Hello, today we're going to talk about alternative movable chords, which are kind of cool because they're the same as using the traditional power chord shape. The difference is that with the power chords, we're normally only playing the three strings that we would be hitting in a rock and roll context. What we're going to do today is we're going to actually strum more of the strings while we're playing those power chord shapes. And they have sort of a cool alternative sound that work for a variety of different kinds of music and will definitely enhance what your song sound like when you're using it. Okay, so we're starting out, and I'll go through the different alternative chord shapes in this video. So we're going to start out on the 7th fret on the fifth string. We're going to put our first finger on the 7th fret on the 5th string, and then the power chord shape, let me get this finger out of the way, is the you're going to have your first finger there, you're going to skip a fret and move your third and fourth fingers down one string, so there's a fret's worth of space, and they're on, so in this case we're going to be on the fifth string, fourth string, and then third string. Do not attempt to use your second finger, that's too much suffering for your art. You don't want to do that, okay? So the first chord we're going to do is an E. On this one you can strum all the strings, sound really cool. Okay, so that's the first one. All these chords are what are called chord substitutes. They're actually, we're gonna mainly know them as E or B or A or whatever, but they are actually these strange hybrid chords. So the E is actually just mainly an E chord. Now we're gonna move our first finger down to the fourth fret, same shape, so your fingers are staying in exactly the same shape for most of these. On the fourth fret, that's going to be a C sharp minor. And you can substitute it also for C sharp minor 7. And on this one, you're going to play all the strings except for the number 6 string, the E string at the top. Don't hit that one. Okay, so that'll give you that sound, which sounds really cool. Okay, and then we're going to go down to the second fret. You notice my fingers are in the same shape each time. Down to the second fret, that's going to be a B chord. And it's actually a B suspended chord, but you can also use it for to substitute a B minor chord. And definitely sounds cool. Okay, so now we're going to continue on down. This time we're going to take these two fingers, your third and fourth finger, and we're going to just slide them down to the second fret, and we're going to strum the fifth string through the first string. Move over so you can see where that is. The concept basically is that you're taking your fingers and you want to keep them, these two fingers, your third and fourth fingers, sliding along these middle two strings, almost like it was a train track or something, to help keep you going. And so let me play that a little bit so you can hear what that sounds like with chords. Those sound pretty cool. And then there are a couple others that are good that work with that. One of them is one that you can substitute an F sharp minor or F sharp minor 7 for. The official name for that is an A2 with an added F sharp, but you'll never see it written like that. So what you're going to do is you're going to leave your third and fourth fingers where they are, take your second finger, who's been left out of the picture and is kind of moping by himself somewhere, and you're going to put him down on the sixth string on the second fret. And you're going to use the back of that finger to touch the fifth string and make it go dead. So this is one of those times where you actually do get to make it sound like that deliberately. So that's a good thing. Okay, so let me play that for you so you can hear what that sounds like. There we go. So you notice it sounds pretty cool. That same chord shape like that can also go up to the fourth fret. I'm going to just take this shape, just like my fingers are, like they were stuck, and move it up to the fourth fret. And that is that's going to be a G sharp minor 7, which is actually an E2 with an added G sharp. Once again, you'll never see it written that way. A lot of times that chord will show up in songs where there'll be a B chord, which is the one on the second fret that we did. And then you just take your second finger and move it over to the fourth fret on the sixth string for that. Also, sometimes it'll show up where you'll have an A2 chord on the second fret, and then it moves up to the G sharp minor 7. Okay, so those are the main chord shapes that you can use that way. It's really handy as far as changing the sound. Here's a regular E, A, B. I just had the chords just kind of sit there. Here we have the alternative one, E, A, B. There you go. So that's how those guys work, and in the future, I'll use those in songs and show you how that works within the song context. There you go. See you next lesson.